Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Let's go find that shrine that it detected a bit earlier. While grabbing fish. Straight from their homes. It's as if some giant hand reached into your house and pulled you out of it. And it was like, I'm gonna eat this. Man, I forgot I saw that speed up bonus. This direction right here. Oh, I thought I could pick those flowers up. Oh, it's in there if I recall. Oh. Okay, I thought I was gonna have to jump in, fly down in there, but nope. Ooh, it's a test of strength. Damn. I meant to jump back, but it jumped to the left instead. I don't have any weapons out. I was wondering what he was going to do because it gave him the flurry rush option. Thank you. Oh, here we go. Oh, fuck. I thought I was doing a different move. Oh, let's eat the last of the food we got, I guess. I should have some. Oh, cool, thank you for doing that. And not the thing I tell you to. Okay, well, I guess we'll just have to eat the other one of these. Almost out of food. Really gotta, like, actually make food the next time I'm in town. And of course, he was getting health back that whole time because I wasn't hitting him. Can't see what he's doing because he's in the wall. I think he's doing his charge-up thing now. No, he's doing another laser beam. Okay. Oh, I got him, though. I thought he was going to do that, like, that last stand charge-up thing. You know what I mean? It's ready to fire a big old laser. But at least I got pretty decent weapons. My trouble. And some springs. And shafts. And whatever's in this chest up here. Ooh, a frost spear is really nice, actually. In fact, I think there's like a mission later on where you need to show somebody a frost spear. And another one where I think you need a frost wand. Frost rod. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. Since we have this as a warp point now, I'm gonna warp to a village to cook stuff, and then I'm gonna work back here and because good God, I need more food. Okay, the village, it's like right over there. Actually, the shrine's kind of far away from it. In all honesty, let's where's the oh yeah, Kakariko village. I can just fly down the Kakariko village from there. Plus, I should really buy that stealth armor while I'm there. We'll see. I should also stop by the Great Fairy Fountain. Fairy. I'll do that. Actually, no, I'll buy this stuff. It'll make those gosh darn fairies less likely to run when I get. I don't know if it needs to be upgraded first, but I'm pretty sure you can also actually just straight up run up to them. Not sprint, but, you know, like, jog up to the fairies and just take them and they don't, like, run away. So yeah, we'll do that in reverse order, actually. We'll cook, and then we'll buy the armor, and then... And then we'll buy the... Then we'll stop by the fairy fountain. Hey, look, two of the apples came back. I don't know why the other ones didn't. Oh yeah, it's raining. Right, even though it's the forecast shows that it's sunny. Cool. Okay. Fuck me, then, I guess. He's missing chickens, ain't he? Yeah. Sir Link. My cuckoos. My precious cuckoos. They haven't come home yet. Now my wife wants nothing to do with me. My cuckoos are my only emotional support. What'll I do? I'll go find them. Really? Thank you so much.
10 Kokos total. Hopefully you'll be able to find them all.
Well, once I get my tablet upgraded in the game. Oh, cool. Looks like it just now stopped raining. So let's see if that fire's lit. It is. Okay. And, I'll get my tablet upgraded before you even bother with that. Because when you do, you can take a picture of one of the cuckoos he has in his, thing and just track them. So, yeah. Let's see. How much does one of these cook do? Two. Okay, let's just pick up the other one then. How much does one of these make? Three. Okay. It's actually probably good to go with these kind of smaller increments. Because you know, you don't have like a maximum inventory space, so you might as well get that much out of it. I mean, unless it ends up having a sort of like a what would we call it? Like a multiplicative a multiplying effect instead of an additive effect. A big hearty radish, though. I remember that's like a full heal if you just cook it. It's like a full heal plus like yellow hearts. But honestly, I'd rather just fucking have a full recovery at the ready. Like I can never think of a circumstance where I'm like, yes, I'd like to cook numerous of those as opposed to like. Just being like, no, I'm totally fine with cooking one over and over and over and having a bunch of full heals on there. Let's see. Let's be creative. Let's get some bananas. Get a health shroom, stamina shroom, and let's get some rock salt in there. For seasoning. Salted grilled mushroom. Nice. There's a thing you can also do with like these herbs, right? Yes. How much does this give you just cooking one? Two. Okay, let's just cook these in increments of two. Now let's cook one increment of two and one increment of two. Just want to have to cook it another time. And I'm also about to get another heart container, so having three won't actually be a waste. Or, you know, having a six heart heal, I mean. For your bones, for defense. Pretty good, actually. And so the thing is, I think the shrooms can be used for upgrading armor, which I want to hang on for. A bunch of apples. Okay with that. Acorns are used to upgrade anything. Let's just cook some springs and some ambers. Oh yes, the hearty truffles. I think those also become a full heal. Plus like yellow hearts. Yeah. Cool. Big hearty truffle is probably similar to the big hearty radish. Not quite as good, but still really good. I think that's enough cooking. How much food do we have on us now? Oh yeah, like a page and a little extra. Let's also go ahead and get that herd container. Ew. Now let's check out this shop. How much does your finest shirt cost? Actually, don't care about what you have to say. I mean, give me the things. Okay, yeah. Whoa, 500, 700. Oh boy. Can I sell you some gems? Oh, wait, rumor mill. This potentially gives quests, right? Oh. I want to sell. I want to keep the luminous stone. Oh, these are actually pretty good to hang on to, especially later on. And we won't bother with the stealth armor for now. Because there's usually better ways of making money off of gems. That's just kind of if you want like really good, quick returns on it, you just sell them. But I know like with luminous stone, I think there's a guy that'll give you a diamond for every like 10 luminous stone you give him, which is great. And we'll grab some fairies. Maybe no upgrade our armor if we're able to. I need to buy arrows. That's actually one thing that's really important. Fly nice and low for me. Fly a bit lower, please. Come on. Yes, yes. What? What? No! Oh, come on! What did I do to give it away there? I was just stealth walking the whole time. Actually, I think when you flew over me, I wasn't even stealth walking. It didn't give me the option to capture you. I mean, you know, I wasn't even walking. I was still in stealth, but... Hmm. Ooh. Also, I think you can only get 3 fairies in master mode. In normal, you can get like 5. Oh, well, let's head back to where we were before. Actually, we should start at this shrine, or this tower, actually, and just fly as close as we can. Alright. To the north. Okay, yeah. Oh, this is the tutorial land. I didn't even think about where it was. I've marked that one, right? Yeah. I think that's a Croxy. Yeah, it's one of those windmill things. And I mean, I'm gonna be around that height anyway, so... Not like I'm losing out. Well! This is a no-go. But I'll be sure to pin this. Stamp it. Croxy. I think that's what it's supposed to be. It's like a leaf, but I use it for Croxy. Really need to get more arrows. Oh, I don't want to waste this weapon. Especially on these guys. These are like the weakest of the undead guys. Oh, wow, I was able to pick up all those things? How few weapons do I have? I mean, I guess a lot broke on the one guy. I should use these for now then. Oh, a memory! Now that I've remembered one memory, I can go get that little piece of armor from Impa.
From here, we'll make our way to Goron City. Then, we'll need some adjustments on that divine beast so Daru can manage it as easily as possible. He's figured out how to get it to move. However, it's apparent that we still have much more to learn. But to think, that divine beast was actually built by people. That means we should be able to understand how it works and how to use it to our advantage. These divine beasts... So much we don't know, but if we want to turn back Calamity Ganon, they're our best hope. Tell me the truth. How proficient are you right now wielding that sword on your back? Legend says that an ancient voice resonates inside it. Can you hear it yet, hero?
Hey. That's not where anyway, that's actually going to do it for this episode, guys. In the next episode, we're going to make sure we get to that tower, and I'll see you then.